JT Show.
Welcome to another episode of the Smash JT Show, my weekly episodic adventure discussing divisive issues in the video game industry and beyond sometimes. It airs every Friday. Like always, if you're new here, hit that subscribe, bell for notifications, the like if you enjoy what I'm doing, thumbs down if you think I suck, and let's just press start. For this episode, we gotta talk about the elephant in the room, and that is the whole violence in video games mixing with these crazy mass shootings that keep happening everywhere. Now, I try my best to keep a positive attitude while doing my videos, but in all honesty, all the tragedies that have been happening recently in the country and everything that's transpired, it feels like almost on a weekly basis now. It's to the point of turning your stomach and making you sick. I can't even go out with my family to a crowded area without thinking in the back of my head, what could happen if there's a crazy person here and somebody that just wants to see terrible things happen? And that is where we find ourselves as a society. Now, this entire situation has been talked about quite a bit by a lot of people, but the biggest thing that really struck me this week is how the media has been portraying video games related to gun violence, and that's why there's such an epidemic in America. Because apparently video games aren't violent in the rest of the world. I have a really hard time trying to wrap my head around the political agendas that people take. And while typically this channel steers clear of politics, when it starts impeding on video games, which is what this is all based upon, the enjoyment they bring to everybody's lives, and then you see people that have no idea what a video game even is, and then try to correlate that into a massive tragedy and trying to make a direct connection between the two, when there are countless studies saying that there is no connection between the two. There is literally nothing that has to do with playing a violent video game and becoming violent in real life. No matter how many times studies are run, it seems to be the trend to go in that direction instead of, oh, I don't know, fixing the problem where it lies, which is typically boiled down to mental illness, and however people define that, there are varying degrees of it, and sometimes it may be exacerbated by taking medications and maybe not feeling right, but whatever it may be, back to the point of all of this, it has nothing to do with video games.
When you look at these photos of how it took place, you can see the actions within video games. Right. The idea of these video games to dehumanize individuals, to have a game of shooting individuals and others, I've always felt that is a problem for future generations and others.
And ignore at the federal level particularly, where they can do something about the video game industry.
What about video games? So many of these school shooters and others have been sort of raised on a diet of violent video games.
And the games we play and the people we interact with in person and on social media that send people into spirals or into dark places.
And I see a video game industry that teaches young people to kill.
So those are a few news channels that ran with this as fast as they could. Before the bodies even turned cold, they were talking about how violence in the real world is caused by these kids playing violent video games. Which, again, there are countless studies saying that there is no correlation, but you have government officials in high positions saying that there are countless studies saying that there is a connection, when there's not. And nobody's pushing them to follow up on that because the people interviewing them are on their side. They're just looking for reasons to rationalize why video games are the bad guy when they're not. And honestly, I don't know how many times we're gonna beat this to death, but video games are not the issue here. The violence is due to mental illness, the medications people are taking, the situations they run into in the real world, whatever their family structure is like, the financial difficulties they run into. But video games are not even on the radar when it comes to this.
If I were a betting man, I'd say that he probably logs 6 to 8 hours a day playing one of those, you know, Fortnite or one of those video games where you're doing nothing but dehumanizing people by blowing their heads off one after another after another.
But it doesn't even stop there. Now we have Walmart reportedly saying that they are going to take down all of their advertisements that show any related violence in video games in any of their stores. They're taking them down. There aren't going to be any kind of promotional materials for any kind of games that may portray violence for people to see while they're in a Walmart. These same Walmarts that sell guns. I mean, I try not to laugh at this, but it's just the irony kills me. When you take a step back and look at the situation for what it is, the idea of Walmart removing any kind of violent advertisements in their video game section because there was a shooting in an El Paso Walmart. Why is Walmart still selling guns if there was a shooting in that Walmart? The correct reaction, maybe knee-jerk, would be to remove the weapons from the store. That, even though I wouldn't necessarily agree with it, would make far more sense than blaming the video games as the culprit. And this right here is the biggest concern that is taking place. It is the start of the slippery slope that everybody was concerned about. Walmart, one of the biggest retailers on the planet, is taking a knee-jerk reaction to video games, not to the weapons, not to the mental health. They still have the pharmacies, they still have the weapons, but no, now they're removing violent advertisements in the store. Maybe there are like Call of Duty showing bullet shells. I don't know what they could possibly be taking down in Walmart stores that would be removing the violence in video games in the advertisements. But Walmart has sent a memo out to their employees, and according to Twitter, said immediate action, remove signing and displays referencing violence. Review your store for any signing or displays that contain violent images or aggressive behavior. Remove from the sales floor or turn off these items immediately. Use your best judgment when determining whether an element is appropriate. If you are unsure, remove the item or turn it off as a precautionary measure. What I need to do, turn off or unplug any video game display consoles that show a demo of violent games, specifically PlayStation and Xbox units. Anderson merchandisers will be in your store to update these demo units within the next week. Wow, we are headed down a glorious path in this country that Walmart is taking immediate action, knee-jerk reaction against the video game industry that did nothing wrong. But oh boy, the media loves to blame video games, and here we see action starting to take place, ruining years of hard work that we've all taken in the video game industry, making strides towards acceptance and allowing people the freedom of playing these games and having the violence and knowing that you're full damn well able to because you're a grown-ass adult and you can choose to play the game or not. No one's forcing you to, and these violent advertisements that are up or these display units need to be taken down immediately. Cancel any events promoting combat style or third-person shooter games that may be scheduled in electronics. Verify that no movies depicting violence are playing in electronics. So not only video games are the issue, but they've extended it to movies now. Violence can't be playing anywhere because that's gonna make people go crazy, apparently. That's the direct connection that I'm seeing here. The knee-jerk reaction that is going to take years to mend because these corporate bigwigs think that this is the issue and this is what they're gonna tell the public to ease their minds, to make them feel like everything's warm and fuzzy and this kind of thing won't happen again. You freaking kidding me? What are you gonna do the next time this happens? Next week? The week after that? Are you gonna keep blaming video games? Are they somehow gonna make them illegal to sell? Are they gonna keep going down that road until they've completely gone and said no more video games that are violent are allowed to be sold or created or made or done anything with? And then more violence is gonna happen? What are you gonna blame then? I saw a meme the other day that pretty much depicts everything I'm trying to say, sums it up really nicely. Violence has been a part of humanity since the beginning of time. Technology, entertainment, anything that depicts violence in that form of media did not cause this, it didn't start a revolution in it, and it certainly isn't gonna be the end of it because this started long before entertainment came in electronic form, and this kind of thing will be around long after any of these electronics are made illegal to use or anything like that. So blaming video games, technology, movies, the entertainment industry at large is so juvenile, it's so knee-jerk, it's so corporate that it makes me sick. That would be like me saying, I'm gonna stop selling Smash JT shirts with the zapper on it because, ooh, that's a gun, and kids used to play with guns on the NES, so now they've grown up and they wanna go to a Walmart and shoot it up. Really? Turn off any hunting season videos that may be playing in sporting goods. Remove any monitors or displays that show the videos. But keep selling those guns, because apparently if people are watching this on the monitor, it might make them think, oh, I can buy a gun and shoot somebody. But if I don't see that, then that's not gonna happen. Okay, gotcha. Couldn't have anything to do with their mental health. Couldn't have anything to do with surrounding circumstances in their life. No, it has to do with an advertisement in an aisle in Walmart. That's what we're boiling this down to.
Must stop the glorification of violence in our society. This includes the gruesome and grisly video games that are now commonplace. It is too easy today for troubled youth to surround themselves with a culture that celebrates violence. We must stop or substantially reduce this, and it has to begin immediately.
I need to be real with you guys and tell you how gross this is to me, the direction everything is headed. Thanks to the mass media having an agenda, instead of looking at the real issue and trying to solve the problem, they are pointing fingers at each other, at video games, at the entertainment industry at large, and then saying, that's what the problem is, let's get rid of all that, and then we'll fix all of this. Even though all those things exist in other countries, what makes America so violent? What makes this keep happening? How about we start asking some real questions instead of just attacking an agenda to get clicks, views, and attention to whatever form of media you're coming from? Anyways, that's where I am going to leave that topic. I'm a little bit heated about it, if you can't tell, but I'm sure there may be another side to this. I'd be interested to hear what you guys think about this entire disgusting situation, especially with what's going on with Walmart and them taking down all this entertainment stuff. Like, that's a scary, slippery slope that Walmart is starting right there. Anyways, moving on to the smashing video of the week, I gotta highlight FerrisWheelPro. Joey over there made a video talking about why the Wii U is amazing, and this video, it's just such a great video. You can tell he put a ton of time into it, lots of thought and effort, and he really made a case to why the Wii U has a special place in his heart and why it kind of never got the attention it should have gotten because of various reasons that he goes into in that video.
You are not a mistake.
If you got some time, definitely check it out. I'll put a link in the description below. And that's where I'm going to leave this week's episode. But as always, I want to say a special thank you to all the Patreons listed next to me here that help support the channel on a monthly basis. If you're interested in joining them for as little as $1 per month, I'll put a link to it right there. And if you still haven't subscribed to the channel, you like what I'm doing, there's a subscribe link there. And last week's video, I did a collab with Cannot Be Tamed. Put it right here. Really good video. Check it out if you missed it. That's all I got for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, you stay smashing.